NAD plus and FAD plus are two molecules that are essential for the synthesis of ATP during cellular respiration. So NAD plus is known as nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, and FAD plus is known as flavin adenine dinucleotide, and both of these molecules are cofactors. That means they are non-protein molecules that assist enzymes involved in cellular respiration. Now, what exactly is the purpose of these two molecules? Well, basically, they accept the high energy electrons that come from fuel sources that we ingest into our bodies, including sugars and fatty acids. So NAD plus and FAD plus molecules accept electrons, and they carry these high energy electrons onto the electron transport chain found in the inner mitochondrial membrane. And the electron transport chain uses these high energy electrons to synthesize ATP molecules. So we see that although NAD plus and FAD plus molecules are not a direct source of energy, they are used to actually form the energy molecules that are used by the cell, namely adenosine triphosphate or ATP molecules. Now, when these electron carrier molecules accept our electrons, they are reduced. So the fully reduced form of NAD plus is NADH, and the fully reduced form of FAD plus is FADH2. So we see that our electrons, the high energy electrons, are accompanied by hydrogen ions. So that means when our NAD plus accepts those two electrons, it also accepts a single H plus ion to form the reduced version of our nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. And when FAD plus accepts those two electrons, it accepts not one, but two H ions to form the reduced version of flavin adenine dinucleotide, our FADH2. Now, in which processes do we actually form our NADH, and how is it exactly used to synthesize our ATP molecules? Well, NADH molecules are formed in glycolysis, which takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell. And NADH molecules are also formed in pyruvate decarboxylation and in the citric acid cycle, also known as the Krebs cycle, which takes place in the mitochondrial matrix. Now, once we form our NADH molecules, those NADH molecules then travel to the electron transport chain. Now, the electron transport chain is found in the inner phospholipid bilayer membrane of the mitochondria that is shown on the board. So we have the mitochondrial matrix, we have the inner membrane, the intermembrane space, and our outer mitochondrial membrane that is not shown, which is found somewhere here. Now, basically, the electron transport chain is a series of four protein complexes. Protein complex 1, 2, 3, and 4, as well as a protein complex known as ATP synthase. So when we synthesize NADH, it basically goes onto protein complex number 1, also known as NADH dehydrogenase. And this complex basically accepts our electrons from the NADH, and it oxidizes it back into the NAD plus. And those two electrons are then carried from complex 1 to complex 3 and to complex 4. And in the process, as the electrons move, we basically pump H plus ions into the intermembrane space from the mitochondrial matrix, and this establishes an electrochemical gradient. And then the ATP synthase enzyme basically uses our H plus ions, uses our electrochemical gradient to synthesize our ATP ATP molecule. So because we have a higher concentration of H plus ions in the intramembrane space, these H plus ions will move down their electrochemical gradient from the intramembrane space to the mitochondrial matrix. And this movement down the electrochemical gradient that was established by protein complex 1, 3, and 4 synthesizes our ATP molecules from ADP molecules, so adenosine diphosphate and our adenosine triphosphate. Now, we see that for our NADH molecules that are formed inside the mitochondrial matrix, and this includes the NADHs formed in pyruvate decarboxylation and the citric acid cycle, for every one NADH molecule formed, we form three ATP molecules. So when we oxidize one NADH on complex number one, we form three ATPs. Now, for one NADH that is formed in glycolysis, which takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell, a net of two ATP molecules are produced, and that's because a single ATP must be used to actually transport that NADH from the location where glycolysis takes place, the cytoplasm, into the mitochondrial matrix where our electron transport chain is found. Now, what about our FADH2? Well, FADH2 is not formed in glycolysis, and it's not formed in pyruvate decarboxylation. It's only formed in the citric acid cycle. In fact, our FADH2 is formed directly in protein complex number 2, known as succinate oxidoreductase, that is found on the electron transport chain. So we synthesize FADH2 inside protein complex number 1, and then we oxidize it back into FAD plus, in the process releasing those electrons. As the electrons travel through protein complex 3 and 4, we once again pump our H plus ions, in this case only 2, in this case 4. And as we pump them, we create our electrochemical gradient that is used by ATP synthase to synthesize our ATP molecules. Now, unlike NADH, our FADH2 only synthesizes 2 ATP per a single FADH2. And the reason for that is because our FADH2 begins on protein complex 2, but the NADH begins on protein complex number 1 to the left. And NADH basically pumps 4 more protons than FADH2 because NADH begins earlier, before FADH2. So for a single FADH2 that is synthesized during the citric acid cycle, when we actually utilize and oxidize the FADH2 and 2FAD, we produce only 2 ATP molecules. But for the case of NADH that is formed within the mitochondrial matrix, we form 3 ATPs per 1 NADH. So we conclude that NAD plus and FAD plus molecules are cofactor molecules that assist the enzymes involved in cellular respiration. Specifically, they assist the enzymes involved in the electron transport chain. So via the process of oxidative phosphorylation, we basically synthesize our ATP molecules by moving these electrons across the electron transport chain and creating this electrochemical gradient. It's the electrochemical gradient that is used to drive the synthesis of ATP by this enzyme known as ATP synthase. And we know that For a single NADH produced in glycolysis, we form two ATPs. For a single NADH produced in the mitochondrial matrix, so in either one of these two processes, we form three ATPs. And for a single FADH2 produced in our citric acid cycle, which takes place in the mitochondrial membrane, we produce a net of two ATP molecules.